Scotty here, how you going? Want 6 wicked goal setting activities? That's what I'm going to give you in this video. I've scoured the internet, I've looked around, I've tried and tested, I've put them into practice, and I'm going to deliver to you on a silver platter. So if that's what you want, stick around to the end. Or not, no pressure, it's up to you. Let's go. Alright, so the first one on the list is the average perfect day exercise. This is a great one. I definitely encourage you to start off with this one. And what you need for this, quite simply, pad, pen, somewhere nice and quiet, on your own, and roll. And when you do it, you want to write out literally, what does that average perfect day look like? Not your perfect day, which is like probably eating all this food and just lapping it up on the beach and diving and swimming. What does your average perfect day look like? The days that you would spend almost, what, 365 days of the year. So what is the average day? And write that out, write out that day. Once you've written it out, visualize it, feel it, see it. What do you hear? Really put yourself in that moment, really be engrossed in that day, in those moments of the day. Once you've done that, the third part to this is to schedule it out. What time are you getting up? What time are you doing the different activities? What time are you going to bed? Schedule out that day so you've got it in a timeline. If you get up at 5 a.m., what are you doing? What are you doing at 9? What are you doing at 10? What are you doing at 12? So you schedule it out. Once you schedule it out, you can then visually see what that day looks like and you can identify where the gaps are. You'll be able to see things that you can already do straight away. Boom, done. But where are the gaps? What do you need to learn? Where do you need to evolve to? Where do you need to level up? And then you can have an action plan of the list of things that you need to do to meet that average perfect day. Number two is the magic wand exercise. You can also use this as a reference to the genie rubbing the lamp. You get a wish. Now with this, you give yourself a minute and it's perfect for when you're stuck on what you want. It's perfect when you're stuck on what your vision is or your goals. Or you're just kind of saying, I don't know what I want to do with my life. I don't know what my ideal life looks like. Where do I start, Scott? Magic wand, rip it out. You've got a minute. Wave the wand, boom. That's what you get as your ideal life. So let me say it this way. If you had a minute given to you by a genie, you rub the lamp and you get to tell them what your ideal life is. And that's the life that you get to live out, to enjoy and to have happiness, fulfillment, meaning, purpose in your life. And you've got a minute to tell them. I'm pretty sure you'd be able to come up with something. So set the timer and give that one a go. Number three is to have a goal setting journal tracking system like this little bad boy. Now, I've done a whole video on this, so you can get me going through it in about 10 minutes, how to set these up and implement these. So I recommend checking out that video. But in essence, it's getting them down on paper. You have a vision, you align your goals, and you track your habit that is going to get you that goal. You can include things like the resources that you need. You can include start, stop, continue exercises. You can do life audits and where you currently are, so you can see the gaps of where you need to get to. You can have your entire yearly planner, monthly planner, and track it and input your projects in there. There's a lot of things you can do with these, and you want to be able to go through these and set it up and do it daily and then track your progress. But these are an excellent way to get results in your life and have things happen, or your wants, your desires come true by having one of these bad boys. Definitely recommend you get that on board and to watch the video I did previously. All right, next up on the list is to do an action plan. Now, this is extremely important. If you're going to want to get your goal, you want to have results, you want your wants and your desires to actually come true, you need to have an action plan. But I know it sounds simple, but so many people will set a goal without the action plan. They'll set a goal and wonder why they don't get it and they don't achieve it. We need to have a clear path, a map, to get from A to get to B. And the way you do this needs to be expertly crafted in a way where each step is just that little bit out of your comfort zone. Because if it's too far out, for so many of us, right, our brain will trick us and keep us in our comfort zone. There'll be too much resistance. So we want to make sure we've got micro steps to lead us there. Rather than having one goal, we want to have the goal and 565 steps or 1,264 steps to get to the goal. And then once you've done that, you want to throw that into a timeline. So you've written out and chunked down all the micro steps that are going to enable you to get the result. Let's have a look at how we can create a timeline for that. So this week I'm doing these. Here's the milestones that you want to set up, and you take those action steps. Then you want to have reward systems set up with your action plan. So every milestone, you have some sort of reward system set up, so you're still getting that little bit of reward and satisfaction as you're progressing through your action plan. This is extremely important, any goal setting, to have this in place. Just a quick interruption, if you haven't already, join the Craft Your Ideal Life Facebook group below. We'd love to see you in there. There's free coaching, there's live calls, we do Q&As, we do all sorts of stuff in there with tools and tips on how you can grow and craft your ideal life and be part of a like-minded community of growth seekers. Love to see you in there. Link in the comments below, section below. Let's get back to the video. All right, next up are the three what's. Three what's. And this is really around questions. Questions that will evoke answers that are going to help you dig deep on what you want and what you desire and think about what truly is important to you and your interests so you can go after results and set goals that are going to help you and align you to your ideal outcome. So the first one is, what would I do if I was given $10 million? What would I do if I was given $10 million? So think about, you know, the old, like, what would I do if I get a lottery? So how would you spend the money? What would you do to invest it? How would you spend your time? What does your day look like if you have been given $10 million? Second part of this, what would I be proud of when I die? What would I be proud of when I die? And you don't have to stick to a single thing. You can list out several things that you're going to be proud of in your life. So have a think about that. You're on your deathbed, you're sitting there, you're reflecting on your life, and you're thinking, yeah, these are the things that I am truly proud of. And then you want to reverse engineer that to create plans, actions, goals, results that you want to achieve in your life. The third what is, what would I do if I had 2 years left to live? What would I do if I had 2 years left to live? What are the sort of things that you'd love just to experience, to squeeze in there? Things that we think, oh yeah, well, because normally we think we're just going about our day, right? And we don't think about all the things that fire us up, that give us excitement, add that adventure into our life, that love in our life, all those things that we would do if we only had 2 years left to live. So if you only had 2 years left to live, write all the things that you would love to do, your bucket list, if you've seen that movie, Bucket List, great movie, check it out. And this is gonna give you some things that you can jam in and start scheduling in into your life today, this month, this year, now, rather than just letting your average life go and then it's 5-10 years thinking, well, what have I done that's really been exciting? So there are your three what's. The sixth and final one is, I got inspired by a channel called The Brain Garage. I have tweaked the exercise and aligned it more to what I like to do, but I've got to give them credit for this, so check out their channel. And here's how it goes. You want to break these up into the 8 sectors of life. If you aren't quite sure what those are, check out this video here where I talk about it in the life audit. But essentially your main areas of your life, for example, your finance, your relationships, your health, your fitness, your partner, your personal development. So there's 8 sectors of your life, and within those you want to have different cards. So you want to have accomplishment cards, you want to have cards that have current wins, and you want to have cards that have future wins. So we'll have 8 sections, and then we have 3 categories for each section. And what you do once you've got those, you'll write in on the cards a win. You'd write in on the card your accomplishment. You write in on the card something that is a future win that you want to achieve. And once you've got your cards written, you then give them a good shuffle. And every morning when you get up, you can go through these and you can look at what you've been doing well in, you can look at what you're currently doing well, and then you can look at the future wins that you want to go after. And this is a great exercise. I did try it out myself for about a week after seeing the video, as I mentioned, and it is actually very good. It works fantastic, I recommend it. And when you come to say an accomplishment, really embody that and then really congratulate yourself and be grateful that you achieved that. And this will also help you prime and stack those wins, prime your mind and stack those wins and give you more confidence to go after the future goals, the future wins. Gives you more confidence, gives you more motivation. So really give that one a go. So there's your 6 tips. Now don't forget to join the Craft Your Ideal Life Facebook group, link below. Can't wait to see you inside. If you haven't already, I'd love you to subscribe to the channel, hit the link below. Give this video a like for me, that will help it and get other people aware of what we're doing here. I thank you. And take care. I'll catch you in the next video.